Here, what you get, sometimes you get some footsteps up here, and you also get a lot of activity.
One Halloween, I was staying here with Mark, and we were setting up for our annual Halloween party that we have here. And he and I were up in the very tower. And as I was coming down the stairs, something made me stop, and I heard this clunk down by my feet. And when I looked down, the Novena medal that I had on my chain had come off and was bent in an L shape.
All right, where we're going to now is the basement.
Anything visual audio down here?
Yeah, we get a lot of women's names down here. A guy on the second floor up in the dining room, and then down here for some reason, we'll call out these women's names.
All righty.
Thank you.
Let me know. All right, guys.
We'll get to
Thanks for coming in.
According to what Mark told us on the tour, they've got the gamut of activity, everything from shadows to full body apparitions to a lot of audio sounds. It's very possible that we're going to catch something.
Let's get this ball rolling.
All right.
If we could get somehow a high shot, get in the whole room, and even down the stairs, that would be flipping sick. But you know what? If that camera drops, it's going down and tumbling.
I mean, we always have those zip ties, too.
Good idea, Tango.
Brian's not here. Pretty much going to be me and Steve. I really want to take this opportunity to really prove to Taps that, you know, I can use the equipment correctly and set up smoothly. So I really want to shine tonight.
Sorry, Steve. There you go.
Perfect.
Thank you.
Now, we're going to zip tie.
There we go. Cool.
Put it high and angled it in such a way that we'll be able to capture any phenomena that may occur, whether it be coming up the stairs or in the tower here. So that's a good location. And I'm happy we did it, Tango. High five.
All right.
I hope you dig our angles. We got them all straightened out and tweaked.
These look great.
This is where the
Spontaneous combustion room.
This is where the boy appears.
That's right.
And this is at the very top, the attic.
Exactly. And then that door is on the left that supposedly opens and closes on its own.
Yeah.
Cool. Let's get lights up.
All right, guys.
Two doors. Yeah.
Tango, we're going up to the tower. One more flight of stairs.
This is Steve and Tango.
Steve and Tango. Good call, Dave.
Yeah, thank you.
Look at you. In the belfry, supposedly whatever this thing is manifests along this stairway and along here.
I'm hot up here, man.
Yeah.
Hot.
Let's see what we got here. In the belfry, supposedly whatever this thing is manifests along this stairway and along here.
I'm hot up here, man.
Yeah.
Hot.
Let's see what we got here.
Steve and I were in the tower investigating, and we heard a loud noise. It sounded like something got knocked over. I mean, we looked around, we even looked down the stairwell, and we couldn't find anything. I mean, we're the only people on that wing of the house.
Well, Tango, let's move down a floor.
Okay.
Probably something, if anything, we would find on our camera.
True.
During the analysis.
Or wireless, yeah.
Or the wireless.
Steve and Tango leaving the tower. Steve and Tango in the blue room, nursery room.
The reason we call it the nursery is not nursery today's date, obviously.
No.
This is where the children were kept, and the servants would take care of the children in this room.
Hmm.
There's probably a very high emotional bond in this room, you know
what
I mean? Sometimes if there's a room or a space where some really extreme bonding went on, say between some family members, sometimes the spirit can feel still attached to that area. If these spirits or beings are attached to the room, we have a better chance of capturing some evidence because they're there.
A lot of voices are in here, right? A lot of EVPs?
That's correct.
So I'm gonna get this going then?
Mm-hmm. All right. Now remember, if you hear it with your ears, it's not an EVP, right?
Right.
A lot of people call everything an EVP, but if you hear it with your ears, you're cutting out electronic.
Yep.
So it's not an EVP, it's just a disembodied voice. Is there anybody in here with us? Can you tell us your name?
Can you give us a sign of your presence somehow?
Excuse me.
Oh, you're scaring me, man.
You want to head in the basement? No one's down there.
Nobody's down there? Okay, good. Let's go.
Jay and I decided to head down to the basement. That was one spot where the homeowner claimed that they heard male voices calling women's names. We got the guy, the girl, and the kid.
At least one of you.
We'll go
if
where
each
the
one
guy
of them
is.
Took a floor, we'd have pretty much a 33% chance. Ah, walked in the cobweb. Still in the cobweb. I think he's rapping me. Kind of a nice quiet night, aren't you?
Mm-hmm. You're just kind of waiting and hoping that you get, you know, that 1% chance of seeing a full body apparition. On a case where you've got reports of maybe apparitions or things moving, you've got that to look forward to throughout the night. The very nature of EVPs is something that you don't hear at the time, something you hear later.
In the meantime, you just chill out and you gotta deal with it later.
Steve and Dave Tango in the basement, Gardner Mass, case at the Victorian Mansion.
Anyone down here with us?
See if we got anything in this room. 0.5, 0.2.
Can you please give us a sign of your presence?
Can you make a noise? Let us know you're here. Now, see this, Tango?
Yeah.
This appears to be older furniture.
Yeah.
Sometimes spirits can be attached to inanimate objects. Attachment to an object can lead to paranormal activity because the spirit is still there with the object, and if you're there with it, you may be able to find